Come on, out you get.
You're new here, aren't you?
So?
Well, I'll tell you how it works.
How'd it go? Any problems?
No. Quiet enough. I had a few words with B. Smith. Oh, she's got a nerve, that one.
There's only one place for Smith, under the thumb.
Hope I've got the thumb for it.
Do remember, though, I have been around for a while. I know you all. Don't try and make a fool out of me.
As if we would.
Do you know what it means to be up in a charge? It means you lose all of your privileges. And on top of that, you may have extra time to spend in here.
No!
Striking.
I didn't.
A prison officer.
Drop the charges against Alison.
No.
Oh, well. That gives us no alternative then, does it, girls?
No.
I am reporting you all.
Oh, you know what'll happen then, don't you?
Yes, loss of privileges. Perhaps a few days in solitary for the ringleader.
Oh, not so fast, Mrs. Bell. Mrs. Davidson is bound to want to know why.
And when she tells us to go back to work, we will.
Yeah, like little lambs. And if any other screw asses do anything, we'll be like little lambs for them too.
And pretty soon they're going to start wondering why you are the only screw who can't get us working. They might even think that you're not cut out to be a screw.
In view of the extenuating circumstances, I'm willing to drop the charge.
I'm sure you made the right decision.
It wasn't really a decision, was it?
Whatever the rights or wrongs of the situation, you made the right decision.
If you say so, Mrs. Davidson.
Oh, I do.
Get out of my way!
Freedom now! Freedom now! Freedom now! Freedom now! Freedom now! Freedom now!
Freedom now! Are we going to be bullied by an unjust authority?
No!
Then let's push on that question, Melissa!
You people are breaking the law!
We're not under the jurisdiction of your law! We only recognize the law of individual conscience! Yeah!
You all right, miss?
Just arrest her for me. She deliberately attacked me.
You rotten little bitch.
You sadistic bitch. Now we know how you really were.
Now that's the one I owed you. This one's for now. I thought we could just get to know each other better.
Is this where I'm supposed to say, all this is so sudden or something?
Oh, Jim. I think you're nervous.
Colleen, if I didn't know you better, I'd say you were making a pass.
Well, would that be so terrible?
You're trying to get me to drop that report, aren't you?
What?
This whole routine is to make me forget that I saw you hit Hennessy.
That's ridiculous. You'd already told me you weren't going to forget it. I'd accepted that.
In that case, what's all this routine for?
I told you. I just wanted to get to know you better.
Doreen didn't spill her food. See?
Don't try me, Edwards. Just don't.
Try it. That's enough, Edwards. You clean this mess up.
I can handle this.
I think it may need the toilet.
You heard Mrs. Morris, Rita. Get a bucket and mop.
I said I can handle it, Ned. Now just go and report the riot to the governor.
It is hardly a riot.
Do as you're told.
I'd hate us to be on bad terms, Colleen. We've always got on well in the past.
Pity you didn't think about that before you criticized me to Mrs. Davidson. No, there's no point in denying it. It's quite obvious from the way she carpeted me that she had a very biased report.
You ordered me to report what happened in the dining room, and I did so as fairly and as honestly as I could. I didn't approve of your attitude towards the women, and I felt I had to say so.
In my opinion, you stabbed me in the back, not only to Mrs. Davidson, but in front of the women.
This isn't a nightclub, Edwards.
Isn't it? Ah, come to the wrong place.
Hey, maybe she's the floor show, huh? Boom, boom, pal. The exotic stripper, huh?
Who'd pay to see her? I've got my money back.
From now on, you're going to be my eyes and ears. I want to know everything that's going on in here.
You want me to inform against the women?
In a nutshell, yes. Suppose I don't feel that's in my best interests. I mean, I do have my own future to protect.
Precisely. That's why you'll do exactly as I say. Otherwise, I could make it difficult for you to have any more visits.
I have a little something that might interest you. B. Smith is now on kitchen duty.
So?
Well, she'll be collecting a little extra shipment in with a normal delivery. A shipment just for the women.
Shipment of what?
Extra food, goodies, does it matter?
Where are you going, Smith?
Taking the dirty laundry to be washed.
Bit of a come down for you, isn't it? From top dog, working the press, to pushing the laundry trolley around. They usually give jobs like that to old legs like Lizzie. As a matter of fact, I'm not sure that this trolley isn't too much for you. Why don't you unload some of the stuff? Come back for it later.
I'll manage.
Okay. No. No, on second thought, Smith, I don't think you should take all of that stuff. Excuse me. Oh, woman with your medical history. You should be careful of what you eat and smoke.
As you are probably aware, Mrs. Morris, due to personal reasons, was unable to accept the position of deputy governor. So I therefore have pleasure in announcing that Colleen Powell has been appointed, and I officially offer my congratulations. I'm sure she will do an excellent job.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Colleen. Thanks.
If I clean up the kitchen, can I stay overnight, Michelle's?
No, you can't. But I'll make you a deal. Go and find your brother, and I won't make you scrape off half that wall paint.
Oh, Mum, it took me an hour to get my makeup just right.
Actually, I think you look very pretty.
Now who's being the con woman? All right, I'll go find you.
Thanks, though. I just thought you might have seen her. Thanks anyway, Kay. Yeah, yes, I'm sure she will be. Right, bye.
Yes, I want to report a missing person.
Wentworth Detention Centre.
Is there a Mrs. Powell there, please? It's about her daughter.
What the bloody hell are you doing?
Well, I was just going to...
You could have ruined everything, you stupid bitch. I'm going to have to teach you to use some sense.
Oh, no, Dougie, please.
Oh, Mrs. Powell, there was a phone call for you just now. Something about your daughter.
What? Why didn't you find me? I told you it was urgent.
The call was cut off.
What do you mean?
Well, it was very strange. A woman asked to speak to you and said it was about Jennifer. Then I heard a man's voice. He sounded angry. The next thing I knew, the phone was slammed down in my ear.
Oh, my God. I've got to call the police. And you haven't had any phone calls there at all?
Nothing. What did the police say when you rang them?
Well, they're beginning to think she might have been abducted.
But why would anyone abduct her? I mean, we're not rich. We haven't got any money to pay any big ransoms or anything like that.
Well, I don't know.
I take it you haven't heard from your daughter yet.
No. There was a phone call earlier, though, from some woman.
Oh?
Yes, she told Wendy she wanted to talk to me about Jennifer.
And what did she have to say?
She was cut off before the call was transferred.
I see.
Oh, it's probably the mother of one of Jennifer's friends saying she's staying there. I have phoned everyone.
Well, she'll probably ring back.
Hello?
Mrs. Powell?
Yes, yes. Who is it?
Your daughter's okay.
Oh, thank God. Where is she? Who is this?
She's okay, but don't go looking for her.
What do you mean? Who is this?
Please, who's speaking?
Hello? Hello?
Put me through. Inspector Lennox, please. Hurry.
Hurt you? I don't want to hurt you, baby. I just want to find out what you're good for.
No!
Well, it's easy. She just poured it all over.
You go and report for this, Gatlin.
Yeah? And then what? The pound?
We'll find out.
I'm telling you now, it won't be the pound for me or anyone else. Right?
There are other punishments besides solitary, and I'll make sure you incur them.
Yeah, you would. You don't even know where your kid is. Or who nabbed her.
Gaffney.
And look at you, you're here just as usual, giving out orders and acting like me.
You got class, you know that? Real class. You sure know where to stick the knife in.
Listen, I don't need support from you. From any of you.
Get your meals and sit down.
Yeah.
I'll go.
No, I'll go.
Any news?
Yes, she's sick.
Oh, thank God. Come in. She's all right. She's all right. Well, where is she?
Quite a way out, I'm afraid. They were heading for Adelaide, spent the night at a motel. Apparently there was an argument and one of them was shot. The other took off with Jenny, dumped her in the middle of nowhere. She managed to make it to a service station and woke the owner.
But she's all right.
A bit shook up, of course, but apparently quite well. Luckily it was a calm night.
Well, when can we see her?
I'm just about to go and pick her up now.
Well, we'd like to go with you, if that'd be all right.
I can't see why not.
Raped. I'm afraid so, Mrs. Powell. It's an ugly thing, I know, but...
She was all right. You didn't say anything
I didn't know anything until we got
here. Didn't know? Oh.
Gosh, baby.
That's the last time we'll send you out on the messages, young girl.
Take her to the car.
Is Carol Lewis, where is she?
She'll be transferred to the city watch house later on today. But you won't be able to see her.
No. I can wait until she comes to me. I'm the deputy governor, Lewis. My name is Powell.
There's no need to, Colleen. I can handle this.
It's an order. Meg, would you patrol D block?
Well, Joyce Barry's in D block, you know that.
Face the wall. You won't give him permission to turn around. Your name is Carol Francis Lewis, is that correct?
Yes.
You are charged with being an accessory to armed robbery, accessory to murder, abduction, accessory to rape, and you are charged with murder. You are to be remanded here until your trial, is that correct?
Yes.
You'll go through there, you'll change, and you'll report to the sister for a medical examination. Well, go on. Move it. Have you any questions?
No.
No what?
No, Mrs. Powell.
Hurry up, Lewis. You're on cleaning duties today.
What?
I want to see the rec room spotless before lunchtime.
Why? What have I done?
You're obviously not familiar with the rules in here. Answering an officer back can land you in solitary.
All right, what's all the fuss about?
Lewis says she cleaned it up, but see for yourself.
Do any of you know how the room got into this mess? Susie?
No, Mrs. Powell.
Very well. If Lewis cleaned it, as she claimed, we can't blame her for its present state, can we? And since there's no other explanation, I'm going to hold you all responsible.
Oh, come, Moppet!
You've all lost privileges for a day.
Are you satisfied
now? Enough! Get outside, Lewis. Well, you're certainly not going to win any friends with that kind of behavior, are you? Right, after lunch, you can help Birdsworth in the kitchen. Let's hope you're better at that than you are with cleaning.
I did clean that room. Why won't you believe me?
Am I free to go now? I mean, am I officially released?
You can go.
In that case, Mrs. Powell, you know, you could be quite nice, really, if you weren't such a miserable bitch.
Caroline Frances Lewis, you have been found guilty by a jury of your peers of the charge of manslaughter, and this court sentences you to 3 years' imprisonment to be served concurrently with your other sentences.
Mrs. Powell, I'd like...
Forget it.
I'm sorry.
What's this doing here?
Evidently some idiot truck driver brought them in and dumped them there.
Well, didn't you tell him to take them through to the loading bay?
I'm sorry, I wasn't here.
Turpentine, we didn't order this.
Well, I didn't think so. I can't find an order for it.
It's ridiculous. We only ordered 2 cartons for the print show. Oh, God, isn't that typical? The rest of it should have been delivered to Woodridge. Well, look, we can't have it cluttering up reception. Get it removed to the East Wing storeroom for now, and they can take it out of there later. I can't believe how the fire spread so quickly. There wasn't time to do anything. How could that happen?
Well, we're still waiting for the forensic report, but it seems that it started with an explosion in the storeroom.
In the storeroom?
There's several cartons of turp stored there, and there's a lot of electrical wiring in that room.
But how could anybody be so careless? I mean, that's criminal.
That's what we'd like to know.
Well, I'm afraid it was me.
What?
Are you saying that you are the person responsible for storing an inflammable liquid so close to all that electrical work?
That's right. But it was only meant to be temporary.
Mrs. Powell, I'm sure I don't need to explain to you the implications of your admission.
No, Sergeant. No, you don't. The fire. The police think it started when some turps exploded in the storeroom.
Yes.
I put the turps in there.
You realize what you're saying, woman? Do you know what your negligence could do to the department?
If there's anything I can do to...
No, just a minute, just a minute. There must be some way out of this. If it can be proved that the women themselves were at fault, then the department will have no...
Department? My God, it's always the bloody department. 2 women a day. You couldn't care less as long as the department gets off the hook.
Don't put that little outburst down to your overwrought condition, Mrs. Powell. The department must be cleared of all blame. If we can clear the deputy governor at the same time, so much the better. If not... We would have to regretfully accept your resignation.
Thank you. Well, according to the forensic report, the fire was started by a fire bomb, not an electrical fault.
Then it wasn't the turps?
Not directly, no. It doesn't alter the fact that it should never have been stored there, but under the circumstances, we can't hold you solely at fault.
Colleen!
Val! Good heavens, what are you doing here? I'm sorry, it's past visiting hours.
She's not a visitor, she's a guest. Take Lawson to the showers.
So, how have you been?
Fine. Knew each other years ago.
Oh, you've no idea what a relief it is to find you here. I'm scared stiff.
Well, you haven't got long. You should be all right. An old friend of mine came in with Lawson.
Oh dear, I don't envy you that.
Oh, I haven't seen her for 18 years or so. She introduced me to Patrick. Bit of a competition between Val and me. What are you doing in this place in the first place?
Oh, got unlucky, I suppose.
But what's wrong? What made you steal from a department store?
Well, I'm not the only one. They all walk out with a few souvenirs when they knock off.
It's so risky.
Yeah, well, you know me, Valerie Jacobs, thrill seeker.
Bit different when you end up inside as a result.
Yeah, well, I've realised that.
Did the other women know you know me?
That girl, Patty, realised when I came in.
Yes, well, I'd keep it very quiet.
Ooh. Sorry, Mrs. Powell, we just found something real interesting.
Yes, well, you've had your laugh, so get on with it.
Excuse me, Mrs. Powell, but we were just talking about relationships and stuff, and I was wondering, do you have any tips on how to get yourself a husband?
Keep the petrol tank on empty?
No, but really, Mrs. Powell, do you reckon it'd work?
That's enough.
Well, it sounds real romantic to me. Oh, I don't know. I think it depends on how many bottles of Spanish rosé you've been drinking, but it ain't too romantic when you're behind a bush in the middle of nowhere.
One more word and you'll all be sorry. Now just get out there.
I reckon she's a rosé girl.
Jacobson. What the hell do you think you were doing?
Just talking about old times. You remember the way things used to be. Anything wrong with that?
You must be joking.
Well, I only told them things you've told against yourself 1,000 times.
To other friends, for God's sakes, not a bunch of prisoners.
Oh, so what? At least they think you're human now, which is more than they did when I first walked in.
Oh, you idiot. They will use that information against me the first chance they get.
I don't think trapping Patrick in the Never Never and having to duck behind a bush is going to do a lot of harm.
That is hardly the point, and you know it. What the hell's got into you?
That's what I want to know. What happened to the girl who used to enjoy a drink and a few laughs?
She became a prison officer. And a bloody good one, too.
Oh, don't give me that. Oh, I know it's a tough job, but don't tell me it's taken all the life out of you.
Well, what do you think working in a place like this does to you?
Well, then get out, Colleen. Get out.
I happen to think it's a very important job. Somebody has to look after people like them.
I'll be sorry to see you go. I'd like to keep in touch.
Well, that might be a bit difficult.
Why?
Well, it's been very pleasant and I've enjoyed your company. But there's no reason to see each other once we go back.
Does there have to be a reason?
I'm married.
I'm married too, but I'd still like to see you. Does your husband go away much?
Funny, isn't it? I used to think I was happy, but what have I got to show for it? A conviction and a guy who dumped me. Lucky you. You've got 2 kids and a husband who loves you very much. It must be good to feel secure.
No lunch. No dinner. I might have saved Valerie some time, but compared to me, she really doesn't have much. She's got nobody, and I have a family. I wouldn't want to hurt them.
I'm sorry.
So am I.
Now, if I were deputy governor, I
would... Which you're not. Okay. Let's get something straight. I don't like you. You shouldn't even be here. With feelings running so high, I would have kept you on sick leave until things quieten down. However, you are here. So you'll just remember. I'll decide what action to take, and you will follow the orders.
Good. We both want the same thing then. A quiet, efficiently run prison. Because if there's any more trouble, some of us may not be as good at holding on to our jobs as others.
Can't you see it is no good between us anymore?
No.
Yes! And face it. I have to. I don't like it any more than you do. I feel like a stranger every time I walk in here now. I can't communicate with my own children. Things between you and I, well, they've never been worse.
So what do we do?
I'll let you know as soon as I find somewhere.
Colleen, please, we can work it out here.
No, we can't.
Look, what is it I've done wrong? Tell me. Look, I'll change.
Please.
If you just...
Don't do that. I'm sorry, darling. Jenny, I know, I'm being unfair. I'm asking an awful lot of you, but please try and understand. Well, I don't know. It might only be for a few days. No, don't. Come on, darling. Don't cry. Everything is going to be all right. You'll see.
Table for two?
No, for one, please. Sorry, after you.
I booked a table for one.
A name, please.
Mrs. Powell.
Just a minute, please. Well, we're pretty busy. We've got a large party coming in at 9. Would you be prepared to share?
I did book.
I wouldn't mind.
Madam?
No. I suppose that'll be okay.
If you'd rather not.
No. Sure, it'll be fine.
Are you on holidays or business?
No, actually, I'm in the process of moving house, so I'm staying here at the hotel. I work at Wentworth, the prison.
In administration?
No, I'm the deputy governor.
You know, it's always fascinated me, the penal system. Do you think it's the system's responsibility to rehabilitate or merely punish?
I'm really sorry.
So am I. Sorry I couldn't help you forget a few of your problems for a little while.
Well, that would take too long. And I don't think you've got that much time.
Unfortunately, I don't think I have either. Good night.
Why don't you come and stay with me?
Couldn't do that.
Why not? Doesn't have to be permanent. Just till you sort things out.
Excuse me, Mrs. Morris. Don't want to butt in. But I'm a bit worried about Janice. Stuck in that place with all those... Well, you know what I mean.
Well, there's no need to. Oh, I'm sorry, this is Deputy Governor Powell.
Oh, hello. I'm not asking for any special favours or anything like that, you understand?
Of course not.
It's just that... Well... I mean, she's not really the criminal type. The only reason she's in there is because she stood up for her rights. I suppose you could say she's a bit stubborn for her own good, that's all.
I take it you don't agree with her?
Oh, I don't know. I suppose I just wouldn't have let it go that far, that's all.
Well, I'm sure she'll be all right. It's our job to keep an eye on her.
No favours, though.
Oh, no, thanks very much. Look, that's all I was asking for. Look, if there's anything I can do for you ladies, I hope you'll let me know any time.
Thank you, but really, there's no need.
Oh, I didn't mean it like that. Hell. It's just as well I'm a carpenter and not a politician, isn't it?
Of course, you know what we need in that second bedroom, and that's extra shelving.
Bit drastic, isn't it?
Not really. I mean, you can always do it with extra shelves.
Yeah, if you're sure.
And of course, we now know a carpenter, don't we? Chris Young!
Oh, Meg, I don't know about the ethics involved there.
Evening. Mrs. Powell.
Hello. Your children tonight?
Oh, no, I managed to get a babysitter at last, across the earth. At least they're not under my feet all the time. Or under yours.
Haven't you got any relatives who could help you out?
Oh, no, my family's all in Adelaide. Janice's are all up in Sydney. I've got one aunt. She's stuck out at Castlemaine. That's where the kids think Janice is.
Oh, I see.
Still, I'm not doing too badly. I'm turning out to be quite a fair cook, you know that? Kids were getting fed up with having beans on toast every night. You on your own tonight?
Meg's late shift, yeah.
Oh, yeah, right. Oh, hello, Mrs. Powell. I've come to see my wife.
Sign in, please.
Oh, yeah. Are you feeling all right today? Looked a bit bushed by the time I left last night.
Mr. Young's a carpenter. He's doing some spare time work at Meg's unit. Extra cupboards, drawers, that sort of thing.
I see. Well, I think you might have let me know, Mrs. Powell. This is not personal, Mr. Young, but for obvious reasons, we don't encourage social relations between the officers and the families of inmates.
This is hardly social, Mrs. Davidson. Meg made the arrangements some time ago, before Janice Young was here. We only found out about the relationship last night, didn't we, Mr. Young?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, right.
Well, it certainly is a remarkable coincidence.
Hello, Meg.
Oh, Chris.
Hi.
Hello, come on in.
This is Miranda, and
Miranda.
This is Stephen.
Stephen?
Look, I hope you don't mind me bringing them along, but there's nobody at home to look after them.
No, that's fine.
There won't be any trouble.
Good.
Hello, you two. Look, I'm not sure what we've got in our fridge, but there's bound to be some fruit juice. Would that do?
Oh, look, whatever's going. Thanks very much. No, Colleen. No,
come on. Here you go.
Well, I'd better get started then.
Right, well, you know where it is.
Yep. I'll just be out here, kids.
Who was that?
That was Chris Young. He can't come over tonight. Something's come up with the kids. Babysitters or something like that.
I thought I'd go over to Chris's place, see if he'd be interested in the housekeeper. I thought one of the women at Driscoll House could use the work.
Well, do you think that's advisable?
What does that mean?
Well, I just wouldn't get too involved, that's all.
Hmm.
Oh, hello. Look, I rang Mrs. Morris this morning and she said, she said it was all right.
No, I know. It's not about the shows.
Enoch, the Eskimo.
Oh. Have I caught you at a bad time?
Said it's tough living
in England.
Do you
need a hand?
I got a safe tip.
Not only are the walls made out of ice, but inside,
even
the blades.
Well, it's only meat, pie and veggies, but you're very welcome to stay.
Really, I couldn't.
It works.
They like you. I like you too. Come on. Why don't you stay?
Enoch. One more game.
Nah, come on. Fair's fair, kids. You can finish that tomorrow.
No, I can't.
Steve, put them away. And put your pencils away, please, Miranda.
I'll help you.
Dad, is Mrs. Powell
going to
stay
tonight? No, love, I've got to go home to my place. As a matter of fact, I better make a move now. Thank you all for a very nice night and a great dinner.
Oh, well, next time we'll have to see if we can do a bit better than meat pie and veggies, eh?
Thank
you. I'll be in touch. Night.
When's he coming over again, Dad?
Well, I don't know, love.
Do you like her? I do.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. I think she's very nice. Hey, now come on, it's bedtime. Mm-hmm. And you too, mate. Oh.
Judy, why I'm here is I was wondering whether you knew of anyone who needed a job.
Oh, yeah? What kind of job?
Housekeeping. It wouldn't be permanent. Bit of cooking and cleaning for a father and two children.
Ah, wife inside, huh?
Mm.
Know anyone?
Yeah. Do I? I'll get it. Hey, Sally, come here a minute, will you, honey?
I'll be right down.
You'll like her. She's a nice kid.
Well, there's not much to the job, but would give us some extra money.
Hello.
Sally.
Sally, this is Mrs. Powell. This is Mrs. Morris. And they might have some temporary housekeeping work for you if you're interested.
Oh, great.
Not so fast. We haven't decided on anything yet, Sally. It's a long way off. Actually, it's the other side of town. Now, do you have transport?
No.
Colleen, there's plenty of public transport. I mean, there's trains and there's buses.
It could cost the poor girl a fortune in fares.
Really, I wouldn't mind.
Oh, let me think about it, will you? Hey, come on. We better get going. Good luck with the house.
Oh, thanks.
Sorry.
Yeah. Oh, bye. Bye, Miss Bye.
But that's the real reason why you didn't hire her, isn't it?
Because she was pretty? Come off it, Meg. I need a drink.
She practically had that job before she came into the room, and then you did a complete turnabout. Why?
It was too far for her to come.
God, she's just a kid. She didn't mind the travelling, and Judy told you she was young before she came in.
All right. Okay, it was because she was pretty. And I was thinking of Janice Young. A few things Chris has said, I get the impression they've got problems. Now, how do you think she'd feel about me installing someone like Sally in a house? And that is all there is to it. Do you want one of these?
I'm having a coffee, thanks. Right, will you still find him a housekeeper?
Yes, I'll run an ad.
Wanted.
One plain middle-aged housekeeper. Mm.
Should have made this a double.
I'm sorry. But you do seem to be taking more than a passing interest in Chris.
Beck, for heaven's sake.
Then why run an ad for him? I mean, he's a grown man. Let him run his own ads.
I don't know. Perhaps I feel guilty about Patrick. If my kids were younger, I'd be doing the same thing for him.
It's got nothing to do with Patrick. Now, Chris is the husband of a prisoner, and you have never, ever shown any interest in a prisoner's private life, with the possible exception of Susie. Here you are, batting around like some sort of rookie social worker. Now, why? I want to talk to you.
I said move it.
Why wasn't I told about that housekeeper? And what business is it of yours?
This isn't the place, young. Get going.
I want an answer.
You heard me. Come on, move it. Listen, you just be damn grateful I helped your family. And if you ever address an officer like that again, I'll slap a charge on you so fast you'll bounce off the walls. Now, move it. What are you doing here?
I just wanted to talk to you.
Are the kids all right?
Yeah, they're fine. They're watching telly.
Well, Pat, I wish you'd phoned before you came over. Meg's had to go to work and...
Picked a bad time, eh?
Well, I don't know what's cooking, but I'm so hungry I could eat it. Oh, sorry.
Pat, this is Chris Young, friend. Chris Patrick Powell, my husband.
Oh, good day. I see what you mean about phoning first. Two's company, eh? Well, I'll leave you to it.
No, look, I've obviously come at a bad time. You two must have things to talk about.
No, Chris, stay.
That's okay.
Didn't take you long, did it, Cole?
Why did you come all the way over here, Colin?
I felt I had to say sorry in some way.
You could have rung up.
Oh, yes, I could have, but I didn't...
And why are you so mad at your old man?
I don't know.
It's because he's right, isn't it?
Oh, of course he isn't.
He knows. So do I. Now, why deny it? Unless you want to stop it now.
Sorry, I must have mislaid my keys.
Yes, she left them at Chris's place. He just phoned.
How was last night? Any trouble?
No. I just came home to freshen up before the next shift. I've been tiptoeing around this place. I thought you were still in bed. I didn't realize.
But it got late. I'm having coffee. Do you want one?
No, thanks. Better get moving. You better hurry along, too.
Yeah, all right, it won't be long.
Hope you know what you're getting yourself into.
Meg, I am not getting myself into anything. I had a night out, that's all.
All right. I'll see you there. Ow!
Wait at the security gates. You have something to say?
You and Ferguson must have had a real laugh. You think you've got it made, don't you? Lock them up and then lay their husbands. What a racket.
I won't pretend I don't know what you're talking
about. Good, then don't. And don't think you're breaking up a home either. I mean, it has happened before, but the others have had the guts to do it in the open.
Listen. I'll tell you this once, young. Nothing happened last night.
You lying bitch!
I worked bloody hard just after we got married. Jan had everything she wanted. All right, we're not millionaires, but we're pretty well off. Kids get everything, they go to decent schools. Jan couldn't fit another dress in her wardrobe if she tried.
Really got it made, hasn't she?
Well, at least she doesn't have to work.
Nah, just a minute. I work because I want to. I've got a job that I'm damn good at, and what's even better, I enjoy it.
Fair enough. It's lucky for you, though, isn't it? I mean, from what you've told me, there's no way you could live on your old man's wages. Oh, come on, love. What are we arguing about? Hell, we've got the same problems. I've got a stubborn wife. You've got a husband who can't get out of his own way. Look, why shouldn't we be here enjoying ourselves? Look, I'll tell you what. We're going to polish off this bottle of wine, and then I'm going to let you talk me into spending the night with you.
Been there? Done that.
I'm going to be works foreman next month when Harry retires. When I told Morgan I was leaving, he made me an offer. It came through this morning.
Pat, that isn't...
Well, the pay's damn good. Maybe now we can get some things that we couldn't afford before.
Well, that's great. Do you realise just how hard we've both got to work at this?
I know it's not going to be easy. By God, I'm willing to give it a go.
So am I.
Chris, aren't you going to say goodbye to Mrs. Powell? Min. Goodbye, Colleen.
Appreciate having my private life aired to Mrs. Reynolds.
Oh, so that's it. Mrs. Powell, anything I said to the governor about you was to do with your professional life. If you insist on mixing the two, then I'm afraid you have to cop the consequences.
Well, there was no need to inform on a fellow officer.
Oh, I am sorry. I keep forgetting how close we all are.
Mind the bitch with a sledgehammer.
Thanks again, Mr. Powell. I really appreciate you taking the trouble. Have keys, so I'll be right from here on.
That's all right. I'll wait with you. Don't want you getting lost again, do we?
Look, I don't want to keep you from your job, Mrs.
Powell. This is my job.
Pretty harmless looking thing, isn't it? Never think. When this timer goes off, this whole room will be history.
Sorry.
I never knew anyone yet that could get this stuff off. But I'm not taking any chances on you spoiling the party.
There's a bomb in there.